Hello, it's Jim from JetsonHacks.com. On today's show, we are looking at the NVIDIA Jetson AGX Xavier Developer Kit. NVIDIA was kind enough to send me a review unit. This is the familiar Jetson box. Let's open it up. Here's the Xavier. Let's see what else is in the box. Okay, so we have the support guide and the quick start guide. Put those aside for a moment. Here's the power supply. Plug for the power supply. This appears to be a USB-C to USB-A cable. Blue indicates that it's USB 3.0. Let's take a closer look at the Xavier. The footprint of the Xavier is 105 millimeters square, and it is 65 millimeters in height. In comparison, let's take a look at a Jetson TX2. The Jetson TX2 is 170 millimeters square, and it's about 45 to 50 millimeters high, depending on how much of the space you leave underneath the board. The Xavier weighs 665 grams, which is around a pound and a half. The TX2 was a little bit over a pound. The developer kit consists of two parts. The top part is the Jetson module itself. The processing components of the Jetson Xavier module consist of an 8-core NVIDIA Carmel ARM version 8.2 CPU, a 512-core Volta GPU with 64 tensor cores, dual deep learning accelerators, these are referred to as DLA engines, 16 gigabytes of 256-bit LPDDR4 memory, 32 gigabytes of eMMC memory, a vision accelerator engine, hardware video encoders and decoders, and a hardware audio engine. As usual, there's more information in the article linked in the description below. The Jetson module is connected to the carrier board using a 699-pin connector. The carrier board has the I/O connections. This is the front of the module. This is a USB 3.1 Type-C connector. This is the USB port that you use to flash the device. Here's the power light indicator. 40 pins of GPIO. And a micro USB connector, which is a serial FTDI to USB connection. Here we have a x16 PCIe slot Gen 4 controller. On the back of the device, we have a micro SD card reader. This can also read UFS cards, HDMI 2.0. Here we have a hybrid connector. It's USB A-Type or eSATA, Gigabit Ethernet. Another USB 3.1 Type-C connector. And a barrel connector for the 65-watt power supply, which is included in the kit. And on this side of the kit, we have the power button, force recovery, and the reset button. Let's take a look underneath the kit. On the bottom side of the dev kit, we have a camera connector and an M2 key E connector. On the other side of this carrier board is a M2 key M connector. You must remove the Jetson module to access the other side of the carrier board. The next step after getting the Xavier out of the box is to flash it using Jetpack. We have another video coming out that will cover that process in detail. I've just finished the Jetpack installation. We're ready to run some demos. The Xavier is hooked up to this HDMI display through the HDMI port, and the keyboard and the mouse are connected via a USB hub. We have just finished installing all the software and some demos. Let's take a closer look and switch over to the Xavier screen. Okay, now we're on the Xavier. Let's take a quick look around here. We'll go to our system settings and look at the details. So here's the overview. 15.4 gigabytes of memory. Processor, ARM V8 times 4. This number is a little surprising because we know that there are 8 cores altogether. We'll go over that in a minute. Tegra Xavier, 64-bit OS. So let's look at the number of cores that are online. It turns out that we can configure the number of cores online using the NVP model utility. Let's query the current mode. We are currently in mode 15 watt. There are 3 main modes, 10 watts, 15 watts, and 30 watts. 15 watts emulates the Jetson TX2. There are 7 different NVP models we can run in the stock configuration. They control the clock frequencies, the GPU frequency, and the number of cores that are online. Let's switch over to maximum performance mode. When we open up the system monitor, we see that there are 8 CPU cores online. Let's close the settings dialog, reopen it, details, and now there are 8 cores, as we expect. Next to the system monitor, we have a GPU activity monitor. The code for this is available on the GitHub JetsonHacks account. It's time to run the demos. This is a CUDA sample. We'll start this baby up. We can see that we get almost 60 frames a second, 300 and some odd gigaflops per second. The next demo that we'll run is one of the VisionWorks samples. This is a Huff transform. You can see that it's trying to figure out where the lines in the road are. Here's another VisionWorks sample. This estimates motion flow. I like this one because it has little doggies in it. And our third VisionWorks sample is a video stabilizer. We can see the GPU usage down here. The CPUs aren't particularly busy at this point. They're all around 20% or so. So let's run more than one demo at once. So you can see that none of the frame rates really changed a whole lot here. There still seems to be quite a bit of computing room to spare. The GPU is a little bit busier now. I would guess it's around 50% usage. Let's take a look at our CPUs. they're in the 25 to 30% range. But it's a nice little introduction to what a visual application might look like on the Xavier. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you'd like more exciting content like this, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.